Poor Joe the plumber with his $250,000 a year salary.
I feel
great sympathy for the man.
Actually, did you see Joe the plumber's house?
Poor Joe the plumber. Sorry?
Did you see Joe the plumber's house this morning?
I did not see it.
It's about an 1,800 square foot ranch house in Toledo,
Ohio.
Yeah, he's suffering. He's suffering.
He's not suffering, but he's not rich.
Well, he's not rich, but he's also not necessarily in need of our sympathy.
Well, I mean, how much do you think
he's not the working poor, Joe.
How much do you think the guys that pay your salary make? I mean, the thing is, you have to have somebody.
You're not going to get me to go there, Joe.
Well, you have to have somebody that makes a little bit of money to hire other employees.
I agree. I'm all for making money. I'm happy for Joe the plumber.
I got no
problem with his wealth.
You're not a socialist. You don't want to redistribute income.
No.
You don't have any Marxist books in your pockets. Who won the debate last night?
I think most, even conservative Republicans have bought on to the notion that the progressive income tax is a good thing. People who make more should be taxed at a slightly higher rate than people who make less.
Don't put me in that category.
Well, Joe, we know you're a fringe character in the Republican Party.
I actually believe it. It's such a fringe concept. I believe we shouldn't penalize people for making smart investments, creating more jobs, especially during an economic downturn. That's what really is stunning to me, that McCain can't explain that the way conservatives used to be able to explain such things.
Yep. Make
a bad investment, Pat, and we'll give you a tax break. Make a good investment that creates jobs, and we're going to penalize you.
You can only write off so much in capital losses, Joe, as I've been finding out.
I don't understand any of that stuff. Hey, Pete, you had a great point about Barack Obama's temperament. And how people were trying to poke him last fall.
I was talking about how for weeks and weeks and weeks, people were yelling at him to call on his inner Chris Matthews or something, you know, to talk in italics, to yell, to holler. He resisted all of it, and it turned out to be what the people seem to want. They want a cool dude in charge.
Well, especially at this moment, right?
Yeah, at this moment. At this moment.
But it's interesting, Joe. Don't you think that if you look at the, if you look over the 4.5 hours of the debate, right? I mean, you made this point earlier today. There were places McCain did better at worse in different places. I think he did better last night than he's done in either of the previous two debates.
No doubt about it.
But the interesting, look, the visual thing. Body language, tone, all that stuff really matters. And over the course of 4.5 hours of the debate, I think people who watched these debates with the sound turned down got the impression of McCain.
While you're talking, let's try to find a split with the sound turned down, because that's exactly what I was about to say. Turn down the sound.
Turn down the sound.
It's a route.
I've had a couple of Republican consultants who said to me that they watch these debates with the sound turned down for this reason. Every time they see McCain, even when he's sounding okay, he looks like the grumpy guy. He is he's like the nega Al Gore. In the same way that Gore's sighing and debate affect kind of killed him in 2000, last night the split screen killed McCain.
Now, you think this is why
he won
lost
these debating points,
Yeah, you think this is why he's lost all three debates, according to the polls, by the same amount, everyone? It almost suggests that no way McCain can win
Because Pat and I are sending down writing points. Who made this point, who made that point? And Pat said McCain won in the first and third debate on points, but visually he got routed.
He got, the rolls of the eyes, I think those register with people. The way he mocks Obama's eloquence, there's sarcasm, there's a kind of edge to it, and there's that, just look at him, he's grimacing and grinching and kind of,
on the other side.
All that stuff just doesn't come across well. It's not pretty TV.
Which Hillary did first.
Yes.
Mocking the eloquence.
It never works.
And on the other side, Barack Obama.
We know that eloquence is not a natural gift like having a great voice. Right. It's earned. You're saying Shakespeare is mine too, baby. That's what happens.
Yeah.
And the eloquence comes from that. And why we're trying to condemn this guy for being eloquent is ridiculous. Mm-hmm. He wasn't particularly eloquent last night.
No, he wasn't.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Pat, that doesn't work. People used to say that of Reagan or say it of Clinton. Oh, they're eloquent. Sure, they can speak pretty. But Americans want that.
Sure,
especially
you cut off
after
the
eight
sound,
years of George Bush.
You cut off the sound of Reagan and Carter.
Yes.
I mean, Reagan is just a handsome, attractive, pleasant guy.
Exuding
and there's
confidence.
Carter, this intense figure, and it comes through. But what that suggests is this, in the television age, McCain couldn't win.
Yeah. Well,
we couldn't
and
win
also
because
Barack
was,
Obama.
Well,
I mean,
certainly not with the contrast of the way that Obama managed to never lose his cool and
he
always
did not.
Keep, and always keeping the smile.
Not.
You know, how many people have commented to you about how Obama's smile? It just, I mean, there's no way around this. I mean, yes. He's a natural. It's an incredible political asset. He smiles and people go. Wow.
It wasn't just the smile, it was his whole open countenance. He was listening.
Respectful.
And then respectful, but then he wanted to counteract. He wasn't angry. He waited for his moment. And you felt that. You saw that. And it was effective, I think.
I think that's true.
I think what's happened is this big shift in the popular culture over the last 15 years. You know, we had blacks as victims in the movies before, but now you got Denzel Washington and Morgan Freeman and any number of black actors who are in charge of the
Absolutely.
Investigation, not the subject of
that
it.
That is correct.
You
know,
you got Tiger Woods and Michael Jordan. Who would you rather have on your basketball team? You know, you'd rather have Michael Jordan.
If Tiger Woods can drive, but yeah, I'd take Jordan. who started really
on the bowling team?
I was saying this. Yeah, exactly. Yesterday, I was saying this.
You need Joe
Bill Cosby.
All right.
In the 1980s, Bill Cosby did more to mainstream the African American family.
Oh,
it was no longer Good Times or the Jeffersons or the jive talking. It was Cosby. They, you know, that family was very middle American. And that, I'm telling you, as a guy from middle America, I can tell you that had an impact.